Hello there, I'm Michael Leedy here once again with a creative quickie. Between the last rendering, after I completed it and I rendered it, and this one, I decided I needed to shave because my facial hair was driving me crazy. So I did that, and so that's what we're doing now. Anyway, in this specific tutorial, I'm going to do my best to make it quicker while creating this banner for my blog to get people to, give them a way to go find out about iPass, because for those who are interested in iPass and make the decision to jump into something that's free that actually benefits them later on, because it starts selling for them once it's launched, I wanted to create this banner for my page. So that's what we're doing, and I'm just showing you how to do a lot of Gimp tutorial things while I create this banner. That being said, I am going to show you in this video how to, we're going to duplicate text, and we're going to add dimension to text. I'm only going to just do one section, just to keep things simple. Let's just do you want it for free today? So what I'm going to do is, of course, I have that selected. I have do you want it for free today selected, because it is free today, and I'm going to go down here to my little duplicate, and I'm going to hit duplicate. Easy as that. So now I've got two things with identical wording on them. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to select on, see, there's two over here. And the one on top is the one that's on top, the one that you see. The one that's behind, you don't. So the one on top, I'm going to go back to my letter tool, and I'm going to literally grab all of it. And then I'm going to go over here to my color. Now underneath is black, so I want to make the top gray, right? Because I'm going to add dimension to my words. So as you can see now, they're gray as opposed to black. Now I may choose to not, you know, do this, but nonetheless, I need to try it to see if I want it to look good. So let's zoom in a little bit here. Okay. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab, see, remember how you just got to keep clicking until you get it. Oh, shit. I had it. There it goes. Right? So you grab the top layer and you just move it off of the black that's underneath it. And do you see the dimension that just happened because I pulled it off of? Here, let me just, I'll do it on this top one too. So this one will be a little bit trickier. Because, let's see, it's this one. That's the iPass 2 that's up there. So that's that 2. Have you heard? Let's move it down here. So I got my 2s separated. Okay, so we're going to duplicate have you heard? And we're going to duplicate that 2. Okay, so then we're going to take the have you heard? We're going to go back over here to the A. We're going to select that. We're going to highlight all of this. We're going to go choose the same gray I just stuck right there because it remembers it down here. I'm going to hit OK. And I'm going to do the same thing with my 2. Except with this situation, because I want the 2, I'm actually going to grab the bottom one because I don't want to cover up the red. I like the red. So what I'm going to do with this situation, because I want to add the dimension to the red, is I selected the bottom version of the 2. You see there's 2 over here, right? So I took the one underneath, I highlighted it, and I'm going to turn it black because I want everything on the bottom to be black. Now, here's a little bit tricky, a little advanced, if you will. So I'm going to make sure that I'm linking together the top two pieces so that the black underneath stays where it's supposed to be. And then I grab the top two pieces. Oh, there we go. Right? So that I can just shift them off a little bit too. And then it adds dimension to my text. And then we're going to zoom out. Command zoom out. See the difference there? Before it was very one-dimensional, and now it's almost three-dimensional. The words kind of pop out at you. So that is how we do that. We duplicate it, and then we just grab the top layer that's the different color, and we just move it over a little bit. Okay, so I'm going to do the same thing over here to get iPass for free, and in the next video, I'm going to show you how to stretch things, because you want to stretch it after you add the dimension, then you want to stretch it so that it all fits nicely, okay? Because then you do this with linking so that everything sticks together. So you only have to do it once. Okay, so we'll see you on the next video in the creating of this iPass 2 clickable bonus link. Okay, you have a great day. We'll see you in a minute.